irritability, kidney stones, and an increased risk of cardiovascular disease. These are just a few of the potential symptoms of not getting enough vitamin B6. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Dustin Williams, and for the best health, nutrition, and fitness advice, make sure to subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell so that you're notified when I post a new video every week. Vitamin B6 is a very important vitamin, and we need to make sure that we are getting enough to meet our individual needs. By the end of this video, you'll know the symptoms that you may see if you don't get enough vitamin B6, why you might need more than the RDA of vitamin B6, and make sure that you stick around to the end of the video because I'm going to talk specifically on why you want to make sure that you don't get too much vitamin B6 either. So let's just dive right into some symptoms that you may see if you have a vitamin B6 deficiency. The first one is potentially a chronic low-grade level of inflammation. From there, you could also potentially see that you don't get enough vitamin B3, because in order to synthesize vitamin B3 in the body, it requires vitamin B6. So you could end up having some of the symptoms that are associated with a vitamin B3 deficiency if you don't have enough vitamin B6. You could also see cognitive symptoms and cognitive decline, such as irritability or depression. You could potentially also be more vulnerable to infection. And you could also see hypoglycemia. Vitamin B6 is responsible for helping you store glycogen in your liver. So if you don't have enough vitamin B6, you may not have enough glycogen stored as a backup energy source, which could cause low blood sugar. There is a specific form of anemia that can be caused by deficiencies in vitamin B6. You could also potentially see soreness, red sores inside the mouth, outside the mouth, also kind of in the angles or the corners of the mouth that can happen from vitamin B6 deficiencies. And I already mentioned earlier an increased risk of cardiovascular disease, as well as the potential increased risk of kidney stones. And also it's been associated with morning sickness in pregnancy. Knowing that these are the symptoms, if you have any of these symptoms and you want to start diving into looking at vitamin B6, the first thing that I'm always going to recommend is that you start by looking at your food. Are you getting enough food that contains vitamin B6, and some of the better sources, are those consistently in your diet or in your diet at all? So whenever we're looking at foods, we have to look at some of the best sources. Now understand, these are not the only sources of vitamin B6, but they are typically some of the better sources as far as the absorption and utilization of vitamin B6. So this is going to come from eggs, fish, dairy, meat, liver or organ meats, and then bananas. Now, if you notice, I only mentioned one plant source, which was bananas, whenever I talk about B6. The form of B6 differs between animal sources and plant sources, with the exception of bananas. It's not as easy to absorb vitamin B6 from your plant sources. So if you eat more plants or if you're vegan or vegetarian, it doesn't necessarily mean that you are guaranteed a deficiency, but it does mean that it's something you might want to pay more attention to, because getting B6 from plant sources can vary individually based on your gut flora as far as how well you are able to absorb it and utilize it, as well as the health of your liver. So one thing that you may want to pay attention to if you aren't eating very much meat or if you're not eating any at all. From here, we want to look into what might actually cause you to be deficient in vitamin B6. The most obvious one to look at is, of course, the food sources that I just mentioned. Are you getting any or very much of the food sources that I mentioned that have the most usable forms of vitamin B6? From there, there potentially are several other reasons that may have a B6 deficiency, or you may have a B6 deficiency, besides just coming from your food sources. One of the first ones that you may want to pay attention to is frequent urination or just loss of fluids in general, because B vitamins are all water soluble. If you find that you have a lot of fluid loss, it may actually cause you to utilize less of the vitamin B6 that you have. Another reason is high levels of inflammation. If you have a lot of inflammation going on, inflammation actually raises your need for vitamin B6. You also need to look at the way that you are cooking your foods. If you tend to overcook foods, especially like your meats and you're grilling more, and if you tend to like things more well done, or you overly cook your vegetables, this is going to degrade the amount of vitamin B6 that you're getting from that food. Another thing to look at is vitamin B2, or your riboflavin. Whenever you eat B6 from certain food sources, it has to be activated in the liver, and whenever this process happens, it requires vitamin B2. So if you're getting enough vitamin B6 from your diet, but it's not being converted into the active form, it could potentially be because you're not getting enough riboflavin either. You can start to see how multiple of these B vitamins play together. You also kind of want to pay attention to if you're on oral contraceptives or higher levels of estrogen, as both of these things can increase your need for vitamin B6. and as well as chronic use of NSAIDs. So we're looking at like aspirin and ibuprofen and Tylenol, any of these non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, if you have chronic use of them or use them on a regular basis, these things may also increase your need for vitamin B6. So what about getting too much vitamin B6? Is this a thing? Yes, it definitely is. Vitamin B6 is one that you want to pay attention to if you are using supplementation to make sure that you do not get too much. One of the first things that you may see happen is neurological symptoms. Thankfully, if you lower the dose that you're taking of the vitamin B6, that typically will remedy it. But regardless, it's not something that you want to toy with. So we want to make sure that we are getting adequate amounts and not too much of vitamin B6. There was also a study done. Now, this was done on men specifically, not on women. And what they did is they tested them on B6 and B12. And for the B6, anything that was above 20 milligrams per day over a longer period of time actually increased their risk of lung cancer by 82%. So making sure that you're not taking too much vitamin B6 over a longer period of time, something you may want to pay attention to, specifically if you're a man. We don't know if they have these same implications for females or not, but regardless, just because it's a vitamin, it doesn't mean that it's okay to take a ton of it. Also, there was some research on the lung cancer as far as too much vitamin B12. I've actually already done a video on this, so I will link to that below in the description. If you want to click on that and watch it, I kind of explain what may happen as far as taking too much vitamin B12 and what to potentially do about it. So how can you get too much vitamin B6? The main way is going to be from supplementation. It's highly unlikely that you're going to get too much vitamin B6 from the food that you're eating. You're usually going to see it in supplementation. Another thing to pay attention to besides supplementation is energy drinks. These are really popular right now, which I'm not sitting here telling you not to have any energy drinks, but they do contain multiple B vitamins. And if you're somebody that you find you're drinking multiple of these a day, you're going to want to see the amount of B6 that's in each one of these drinks and see how much you're actually getting from the drinks on top of what you're getting from the food. Plus, if you're supplementing with it, you can end up taking in more B6 if you're not paying attention to all of the areas that it's coming from. Now, the tolerable upper limit that has been set by the government is 100 milligrams per day of vitamin B6. I personally even feel that honestly, that's probably too high of a dose. I usually don't have anybody go over 20 to 30 milligrams. I have the majority of people start anywhere between 5 to 10 milligrams to see if their symptoms start to subside. If they still aren't seeing their symptoms getting any better between 5 and 10, we may temporarily bump it up to 20 to 30 milligrams, but I usually don't go over 30 milligrams with my clients. Now, if you wanted to take more, my recommendation is that you go see a doctor, you have some blood work done, and you verify that you may potentially need more than that. But without that verification, I typically have clients stay on the lower end, anywhere between 5 to 10, maybe upwards of 20 to 30 milligrams in a day, depending upon their needs. As far as supplementation goes, there's a couple of different supplements out there for vitamin B6 if you choose to experiment with it. I would recommend what is called P5P. So that's the active form of vitamin B6. If you take that one, it doesn't have to go through the process of going into the liver and getting activated and needing the other B vitamins to help with this. You just are already taking the active form if you find B6 that is P5P. Again, as far as starting out, I recommend 5 milligrams a day, maybe 10 to start with to see if your symptoms subside. You can go up to 20 to 30 milligrams from there for a short time if needed, but usually that's what I would recommend that you start with. As far as my recommendation on the actual supplements, I've got links below where you can click and go to. I have a pill form and I also have a powder form. Getting these smaller doses of vitamin B6 can sometimes be hard in a quality supplement. So the supplement that I'm recommending that's in pill form is around 20 milligrams a day. If you wanted to try less than that, then you would have to probably get the actual powder and use it as your supplementation. And overall, as I mentioned earlier, I would definitely recommend that you start by looking at your food sources first. That's always going to be my recommendation. Are you getting enough B6 and where is it coming from? Start there. And then after that, you can start looking into some supplementation, but make sure that you are not taking too much, as a lot of the supplements out there may have between 50 milligrams to 100 milligrams in one capsule. If you want to join a community of people looking to be healthier, I actually have a free Facebook group for you. We talk about health, fitness, we talk about fat loss, just helping people to navigate this sometimes tricky space. I'll put a link below in the description. Would love it if you would come and request to join and be a part of our community. And as always, if you enjoyed this video, I would appreciate it if you would hit that like button. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and I will see you guys in the next video.